In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the classical definition of probability. Find the probability of obtaining exactly 8 tails when flipping 9 coins. And we can express the answer as a fraction in lowest terms or as a decimal, rounded to the nearest millionth. All right, so we need to find the denominator, and the denominator is going to be the sample space. So I'm going to go ahead and use something called the fundamental counting principle to find that sample space. I like to abbreviate that with FCP. So the fundamental counting principle basically says that the number of ways that events can occur in sequence can be found by multiplying straight across how many ways each individual event can occur. So I went ahead and drew little slots for each event, and each event would be an individual flip. So for this first event, flipping the coin the first time, I have two outcomes, heads or tails, so I have two outcomes. And then for the second flip, I also have two outcomes. And for the third flip, I also have two outcomes, heads and tails, and so on. So you'll see that each of these slots will be filled with the number 2, and we want to multiply straight across. So a shortcut for that is 2 to the 9th power. Okay, repeated multiplication of the same factor is raising it to an exponent. That's the shortcut. So 2 to the 9th is 512. So that's going to be my denominator. That's how many outcomes altogether I have in my sample space. Now clearly I don't want to use a tree diagram to find that, because it would have too many branches to fit on a piece of paper. So to find the numerator, and I'm sure there's more than one way to do this, but in finding the numerator, and in looking at the problem, we're flipping a coin 9 times, and we want exactly 8 tails. So if we're flipping the coin 9 times and 8 of them are tails, one of them has to be a head. So one outcome we have for flipping the coin 9 times would be that the first one is a head, and then the rest of them are tails. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Whoops. One too many tails. Okay, so I could have the first flip be a head and then 8 subsequent tails. Now, clearly, this isn't the only possible outcome for flipping 9 coins. I could have a tail on the first flip and then a head on the second flip and then the rest of them be tails. Okay. Or the first two could be tails, and then the third one could be a head, and the rest be tails, and so on. Hopefully at this point you'll see the pattern here. Okay, it isn't enough to say that the first flip is going to be a head and the rest are going to be tails. Okay, we have more than one case or outcome where we get exactly 8 tails and exactly 1 head. So if you think about this head just shifting over position, we're going to actually end up with 9 of these all together. Okay, and you can verify that yourself by just continuing to write out or systematically list all outcomes for the numerator. All right. So the classical definition of probability, in essence, is something out of something else. Okay, so the numerator is always a subset of the denominator. Contained in these 512 possible outcomes in the sample space, we have these 9 where we have exactly 8 tails. So putting it all together, the probability we get 8 tails is going to be how many ways we can get exactly 8 tails. Okay, and that's going to be 9 out of how many outcomes are in our sample space, and that's 512. So as a decimal, rounded out to 4 decimal places, I get 0.0176. And here's a little gut check. Okay, a valid probability is a value that falls between 0 and 1 inclusive. If you end up with a negative probability or a probability greater than 1, you've done something wrong. Okay, this doesn't guarantee that this is the correct answer, but it certainly is a valid probability.